friends, Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And I'm here to give you an update on the cloth wipes that I've been using. Now, I did a video that surprisingly ended up being my most popular video ever of all time and is now my number one spot. But about, you know, things you can do in replacement of toilet paper. Now, I talked in that video how for years I've been using cloth wipes for just for urination and then using toilet paper for the bigger jobs. But after I published that video, after reading a few of the comments of people who've been doing all cloth wipes for a while, it inspired me to go ahead and finally make that change to entirely cloth wipes. And so the smaller ones I still use as I did before, but I cut myself some bigger ones and I'm finding out the 10 inch square ends up being a perfect size. So that's what it looks like. You can do a zigzag stitch all the way around. You can use pinking shears, or you can just hem it if you prefer. I just don't bother. I have so many other things to do that I would rather not waste my time hemming every single one of these, because I like to keep a lot on hand so that I can make the load as big as possible. So here's what I discovered. I wasn't sure in that video at the time. I was thinking maybe you'd want to wash them every day. Now, it's going to depend on the size of your family. If you have a big enough family and your whole family switch into the cloth, you may still need to and be able to wash them every single day. But with just two of us in the house, and really I'm the only one using them, it takes a while to build up enough. Now, if you're washing your clothes by hand or an off-grid setup, it really doesn't matter. And I mentioned our off-grid setup, which I could put a picture of it right here. And when I would wash these in that, what I did was I waited till I washed all the other clothes and then and got them out, rinsed them on all that, and then I would add these to the water that was already there, the soapy cleaning water, and then wash them. And so you can do that with those. You can do the same thing. I still have an electric machine that I use, especially this time of year when we have plenty of solar power. The off-grid setup is just a backup in case we lose our solar power and or our electric machine breaks down. If you have a high efficiency washing machine, you don't need to have a huge load because it's going to adjust itself according to how much is in there. But still, I would prefer not to wash a load with just a few wipes in there. So I've been experimenting, and so far I have easily gone up to 4 days without washing with no smell. Because what I've been doing so far is keeping them in a bucket like this. Not this bucket. This is actually one I just cleaned out because I just finished using it, the coconut oil in it, for soap making. But I didn't want to bring the bucket from the bathroom in here. So anyway, it's a bucket exactly like this. And especially with the lid on, you can't smell anything. I do not use any kind of pre-soak. I do not add anything to the bucket to help absorb odors. If you're concerned about it, yes, you can spray a little vinegar in there, or which I don't have the spray vinegar in here. This is water, and I'll talk about that in a minute. You can sprinkle some baking soda in there. You can choose to do a pre-soak. But as I found with when I did the cloth diapers, I found it better to not have it soaking that whole time because it tends to just makes it more smelly that way. And I find that by not doing the soak, even when I open the bucket to toss in more, I can't smell anything. So what I've been doing, and this might be one of the things that's helping to cut on the odor, is that I keep a bottle of colloidal silver right next to my little pile of wipes. And then here's the one that go in the other bathroom. So these two, this basket here, and these go in the one bathroom, but the bathroom I use the most, I have these and then these. You can see a kind of a little color coordination there to match the colors in the bathroom. So anyway, what I do is I spray this on, and this also has some essential oils in it. This particular one has orange and clove, and it just adds a nice smell, and it also just helps make me feel fresher anyway. The colloidal silver and the essential oils do help to kill the bacteria that cause odors in the first place. So I believe that's one reason why I haven't experienced any issues with odor. And yes, there's going to be those times you get some that are a little bit messier. And in that case, this is where the spray bottle comes in hand. You can also keep a squirt bottle on hand. I really like these particular spray bottles because they have a real powerful stream. And so in that case, I just rinse it off really good, just spray it off directly into the toilet. and then I put it in the bucket. So there's really no solid materials going into the bucket and then into the wash. And then as far as washing goes, I simply use, just like I said I was going to in that video, I use my own homemade laundry powder, which is nothing more than washing soda. And yes, I do know you can make your own washing soda. I prefer to buy it for now, but if I had to, I would take my baking soda and turn it into washing soda, because I do stock up. I have about 100 pounds of baking soda on hand because I go through a lot of it. So anyway, the washing soda and my homemade soap that I then process up in the blender. I have a video on this that I'll go ahead and link to down below in the description box. Remember to click on show more or that little gray arrow just below the video itself. And then right here, I have some citrus vinegar. I have a lot of this going. I keep a lot of citrus vinegar going. I make it myself from scratch. It's not white vinegar with citrus peels added. It's citrus vinegar made from scratch with water, sugar, and citrus peels, and sometimes chunks of fruit as well. And I have a video on this too that I'll put down below. If you're gonna do this, obviously you're gonna need to come out with the method that works best for you according to you, your needs, what kind of washing system you have, your family, and so on. However, all I do is put a little bit of my laundry powder in the wash. I go ahead and pour a little bit of vinegar into that, but I also put some into the rinse cycle. And then I set it, I don't do a pre-soak on it, I simply set it on the longest wash, so heavy soil wash, and they come out smelling fresh and clean straight from the washing machine. And then on sunny days, I'm gonna hang them outside just like I have in this picture right here. And that's gonna kill any possible odors that could be left, and also the UV rays will sanitize the cloth. Now, we can't always do that because we've amazingly enough have been getting a lot of sunny days, which is really out of the norm for our springs. It's usually very cloudy and wet all spring long, but I've been taking advantage of it and hanging them in the sun as often as I can, but I've had a few days I've had to hang them inside, and even then they still smell fresh and clean. I have had no issues with odor. I feel totally comfortable with using these. So again, you know, and in case you haven't figured out, I do this as a separate load all by itself. I do not wash these with anything else. I will also link to that previous video I mentioned where I initially talked about these as a toilet paper replacement. And there's a lot of great comments in there on what people do, and some people talk about using bidets, whether it be the kind that the cheaper kind, convert your toilet into a toilet and bidet. And some people actually have a real bidet that's separate. Some people have what's called a handheld bidet. There's all different kinds of options you can do, and people have a lot of great ideas if that's the method you would rather use right there. Personally, I am sold on the cloth. I love it. And also in the under there, a lot of other people talk who do all cloth, talk about how they wash them. Some like to do a pre-soak and that works for them. So you might want to check into that and see what different people's suggestions. But if you're coming back here or you're one that's been doing cloth, even if you put your comment on the other video, please put it down below how you like to wash, whether you do a pre-soak, whether you soak them while you're letting them build up, or whatever it is. And so that people can get some more ideas that they can kind of adjust it to suit their needs. Because just like with so many other things, whether it be gardening or how you cook and bake, there's not one way that's best for everyone to do this. And so you got to find out what's best for you. And just be careful you're not being sanctimonious about it. I did kind of find out in the other video that some people who are bidet only people acted a little sanctimonious about it. And that's fine as long as it works for them. But I wouldn't look down on anyone who chose to use a bidet. There's reasons why I don't find it something that I would be interested in, and I'm happy with the cloth. Some people might not be able to stand the idea of doing the laundry, but I tell you, it's easy. I only have to do about 2 loads a week. And I'm hoping to get myself down to just 1 load a week. So here was another suggestion I took from that video. I'm gonna get rid of the bucket and go with something that's a little bit bigger. This is a 1 gallon bucket, but I really liked the idea of the hands-free garbage can. So it's got its own lid, and I found one that I really liked that was more of a rectangular shape, so it will fit better in the place that I would like to put it, and it will look a lot nicer than a coconut oil bucket. Here's a picture of it right here, and I'll also put a link to it down below. It comes in a whole bunch of great colors, but you can also go with the round one. So even if you go through that link and don't like the one that I'm getting, I ordered it up, so it's still on the way. You could go with round, you could go with whatever you want. The thing I liked about this one is it also had a removable liner, so that would make it easier just to take that out and then just go toss that, you know, dump that into the washing machine and then put it back in, or take it out and sanitize it if I need to. And so that's what I'm going to be switching to, and that will be a little bit bigger than my bucket. That means I should be able to let it build up for another day. I might even be able to get it to where I only have to do a load of these once a week. And again, I found it to be very little extra work than what I was already doing anyway. And it's natural, and I'm not wasting paper products. I don't need to depend on the store for toilet paper. I'm really, really happy with this, and wish I would have made the full switch years ago when I first switched to the cloth just for the number one. I know it sounds nasty to begin with, but remember, a lot of us did cloth diapers with our babies like I did, and I did cloth feminine napkins as well. And that was another thing that was like an oh duh moment for me, that I wish I would have thought of it years ago when I was much younger, to make my own cloth feminine napkins. And that was the best choice. It's the healthiest choice too. I think it's healthier than all other methods. And so that's just the way things used to be done. And if you can handle doing cloth diapers and you can handle doing cloth feminine napkins, you can handle doing cloth wipes for yourself just as easily. It's actually a lot less messy and a lot less work than cloth diapers were. And so I'm sold on this method. Anyway, so I hope you found this encouraging. And again, if you have to rely on toilet paper, that's fine. At least what I feel that some of us are doing is at least we're freeing up the market more for other people to be able to have access to toilet paper when they need it. And so that way it just kind of helps everybody, not just ourselves. I hope this gave you some more ideas and some more encouragement to consider making the change if you think this is going to work best for you, or even go with the bidet. Again, don't forget to read the comments and in that previous video, and also in the comments down below, and just kind of see how different people do things, and in there you might find a method that's going to work best for you. Just another way to be a little more self-sufficient. All right, well, thanks for watching. Take care, and God bless.